There they are, throwing some souvenirs to the crowd. Tontowi up now from Liliyana and L.Natsir. A year ago. Successful run of tournaments for this Indonesian combination. Four consecutive finals, winning three of them, and then lost here in the final. And now world champions. When we have a premier event, premier this year for 2012. Premier event comes first of two consecutive Super Series events. And I think that's a very sensible move by the BWF, the Badminton World Federation. Some of the players are all fit and ready for the premier events, and everybody's tired after the first one, and of course. We've seen all the best players performing to their absolute ultimate capabilities in the premier event. So the world number threes. The most record for you is impressive, isn't it? Five tournaments played. And they've won the last three tournaments. England, Swiss Grand Prix. Later on the India Super Series event as well. So for the brother and sister, Markis, 27 years of age, for Zebadiah, Bernadeth, 23. And their career win-loss record is the same as their year win-loss record. But please don't pay too much attention to that world ranking of 622, because they've only got two tournaments towards that world ranking, their two previous events. The Korea Super Series and the Malaysia Super Series lost in the qualifying of both. Well, they're both outstanding players in their own right, no doubt about that. And we've lost, of course, Markis Kido. Very famous the world over for his men's doubles, being current Olympic champion and former world champion, of him that I said to you one. Here, Bernadeth, in her own right, a very, very fine mixed doubles player. And that borne out by the fact that this is her third consecutive quarter final at this particular event.
Ready to play?
2 years, reached the quarter final with Gunyarwan. Actually, from Gunyarwan. After the French Super Series last year, he still remains as high as number 8 in the world ranking and looked pretty good certainties for qualifying for the Olympic Games. That was a huge surprise to me and I know there were a number of other badminton fans throughout the world, but that split happened. But not really got to hear exactly why the split happened. What a success these two have been since they formed their partnership in 2010. T.Ahmad and Liliyana, and that's it. Reached the final. The first three tournaments they played, winning two of them, the Macau Grand Prix and the Indonesia. Grand Prix gold event as well.
Ladies and gentlemen, on my right, Markis Kido and P.Z.Bernadeth, Bernadeth, Indonesia. And on my left, Tontowi Ahmad and Liliyana Natsir, Indonesia. Liliyana Natsir to serve to P.Z.Bernadeth, Bernadeth, Lavo, play.
Liliyana Natsir, former world champion, Olympic silver medalist. Camera. It's disturbing her a little bit.
Four, three, one.
Both Bernadeth and her brother, independent players now. Independent of the National Federation here in Indonesia, PBSI. For both pairs, they've got their own coaches. Behind the court, of course, this pair.
5-1.
Still playing under the umbrella of PBSI. Ball set up, called. Racket not facing in the downward direction.
2-5.
So the shot for Liliyana of Indonesia making the court.
Service
over, 3-6. This pair hadn't qualified for this year's Indonesia Open. But I have to say, Markis Kido and P.Z.Bernadeth in their first round played some sensational badminton when they beat the number 5 seed, Chen and Chen Wen-sing, Taipei.
3.
Two straight games as well. He's very, very impressed with them.
Service over. 4-7.
She was right to go for it, because I think that the only way that Sarah might Markis will actually win this encounter as if Zebadiah actually does take the net area away from Liliyana, and that's it.
Istora, 6-8.
Service fault called.
Istora.
Both being faulted. There's great expectation on the shoulders of Tontowi, Ahmad and Liliyana, and that's here after they won the All England title earlier this year. What's in the media here in Indonesia about their hopes for them for Olympic medals. Interesting to me that on the number three seed's coaching bench is Liliyana Natsir's former doubles partner, Nova Widianto, and he just retired as a player. So a 3-point advantage. The number three seeds at the mid-game interval. Only 6 minutes of play. There's the judgment. It's well long.
12-8.
Adventurous shot to try. That is a word. He would have been an outright winner. Trying to turn the defence. He knew immediately it was going to go wide. And the number three seed's now on a run of 5 straight points. And the run comes to an end.
So it's over. 9-14.
Some very short rallies.
Oh.
And I I suspect that's because
11-14.
One pair is seeing you. We're not quite sure exactly. Their brother and sister, exactly who's going to cover which shot and who should be moving where on court.
Tontowi
up and out anyway, by the nature of his play. Has a very, very good smash, likes to go for his shots. There tends to be short rallies anyway with him. Physically strong, look, there's hardly any backswing of the racket. Play that backhand from Markis Kido. Points. That's a pity. She needed a good serve there. Just delightful.
19-14.
Good low serve. Knew where the third shot was going to be. Now on a run of five straight points.
It's
game points. Three seeds apart from L.Natsir.
Istora, 15-20.
Second time of asking.
Was given by T.Ahmad and Liliyana
21-15 confirms the umpire. 14 minutes of play. Moments of brilliance from Markis and Bernadeth, but not consistent enough. Nani Al-Farali pulls off the point. Cumulative pressure in the world number threes.
Court 1, 20 seconds, court 1, 20 seconds. Second game. Level. Play.
Well, I would expect in a way. Liliyana, L.Natsir and Tontowi, T.Ahmad need to push home their advantage. The reason I say that is because this man, Markis Kido, is already through to the semi-final of the men's doubles to be played tomorrow. And it comes with a Sofia one. And we have to play against the number two seeds. Every ounce of energy to beat the number two seeds. So just how much energy he wants to pour into this mixed doubles is a possible question mark in my mind. The only thing I would say is that Markis Kido is such an exceptional player. He has such incredible wrist strength and produces shots from winning shots from nowhere, really. He has the capability, without putting in too much effort, actually, to win matches. He certainly did in their first round. Mixed doubles here, having qualified.
So we score 1-2.
So far this week, I have to say, I'd really like to see Markis Kido playing in any more mixed doubles. 2:57. To suddenly play winners from nowhere.
5-2.
Oh my goodness, that is phenomenal, and just proving the point that I was making a little earlier. No, right, he looked as if he was in trouble, and suddenly, from nowhere, he plays the winner. Turn. Pace on the shuffle to make it very awkward.
8
to Liliyana, and that's it. Determination.
Istora.
Zebadiah.
9-5.
There's no signs to me. The final error from Liliyana, and that's it. But she's beginning to get a little frustrated with this.
Liliyana. Play.
Watch.
Stop his trauma.
Ahmad play with Liliyana, and that's nine. There are occasions where he does play a little bit of walkabout, loses his focus and his concentration. But I have to say, on this occasion, I think it's just that their opponents have been outstandingly good.
Tontowi.
Just putting the players right, and they're in a wrong formation. Wants him to receive.
11, 7, play.
Yeah,
12, 7.
That's here to see their partner. Should I have left that? Would have gone short. Not for any question, really.
over. 14-8.
Markis Kido, I'm awfully grateful that he didn't take up mixed doubles before this. String that. Tontowi. T.Ahmad is not hurt. Dives into the... Oh, dear me, I didn't like the look of that at all. Oof, my goodness. Well, in all the commotion, Markis then... the shuttle out of court when the whole court was wide open. Yeah. Seemed to smack his head into the service judge's box at the side of the court. Knocked our microphone flying. I think another game point has come and gone. Three of them.
place.
Standing in that second game. Oh, yeah, he backed up by his younger sister. There's no way to go into. Back into.
Court 1, 20 seconds, court 1, 20 seconds.
Well, this is going to be fascinating, this third game.
Final game. Love all. Play. Wide. Three, one.
all. Sixes and sevens. Caught again. No shot. Just long. Moment. blocking that backhand. Oh, sincere, I've got a little smile. And I think it's an outrageous attempt. Point advantage.
11-4 in the
match. The first change ends in this deciding game. Not going to make any predictions this time. Strict about all kits must be inside the kit box. position out. From Tontowi, Ahmad actually 11, hit Liliyana Natsir in the back of her head. What on earth was he doing? Well, at least they can both smile about it. I've often thought how desperately they close they are to that happening so often within the game. Semi-final berth confirmed. Emphatic third game. 21-15, 15-21, 21-11 in the decider in a match just one minute shy of an hour.
Liliyana L.Natsir, 21-15, 15-21, 21-11.
The final point, Yera on the defence from Markis. Well, I think brother and sister, and they play more tournaments, could be a real threat in world terms in the midst of his discipline. Because a major upset in the world champions, Jiangnan and Jiao Yunlei. The defending champions here, of course, they've gone down to Sukit Prakamol and Saralee Thong Thongkan from Thailand. 21-17 in the deciding game. And the Thailand pair coming back after losing that opening game. And they'll play against the Koreans, Go Sung Hyung. So, T.Ahmad and L.Natsir know that they'll play against Chinese opposition. We don't yet know who that will be, because Tao Xiaoming and Guan are currently in progress against number two seeds, Zhu Chen and Ma Jin.